Hello and welcome to this video where I talk about 10 different tips and hacks for using Doodly. So it's quite difficult to get your assets centered either vertically or horizontally, and we're used to using things like PowerPoint and things line up automatically and you know when things are in the center. You don't have that with Doodly, so what you have to do is you have to show the grid. You get a very complicated grid, so probably the easiest thing to do is enable snap to grid. That way you can get things more precisely and they snap in the right place. If I wanted to copy this and then paste it, I could easily get it to align using this snap to grid feature. So that's how you can easily align things and how you can easily get things to line up. And tip number two is previewing what you've already done. So you can click here and you can show the preview, but I don't think this preview is very good. So one way you can preview what you're doing on a scene by scene basis is to right click on the scene and click preview. And when you do that, you get the preview for each scene, which is quite useful. But if you want to preview the whole thing in its entirety, you go up here next to the save button and you click preview. And that will preview all the scenes together. So if I want to add a soundtrack to my Doodly video, if I go to this sounds tab, sometimes I find that we've got sound effects and we've got music mixed up and it's really difficult to find things. Of course, I don't really know what I'm searching for when I'm adding a soundtrack. So what you can do is click on this categories and you can then click on music and sound effects and that will separate them out. So if I click on music, then it just shows me the music I've got available. I tend to look for duration, so I pick something that I know is going to be as long as or if not longer than my video. Another thing that's useful is if you go to props, you can click on categories here and you can split them down by categories. So again, you can always search for things in Doodly, but sometimes it's quite useful to split things down and look at things like brands or other things rather than searching directly. If we go over here to our scene settings, one thing we can do is we can add subtitles to our scene. This is quite useful because it gives text at the bottom, which can help really make the video look professional and convey what you're talking about. So we might want to type something like this. This is scene 1 of 7. And we click apply. And what will happen is when we play the video, the subtitles will display down here and it just looks really good. So let's have a look at this. So we can see here, we've got subtitles. I haven't done a particularly thorough subtitle. We're putting this as scene 1 of 7. I wanted to illustrate the ability to subtitle. The next tip is if we go over to settings, we've got all the general settings. And this is really useful because we can set our settings here and every slide or scene will use that setting. One thing I liked is we can change our hand style from left to right-handed or right-handed to left. I'm a lefty, so that's quite good for me. We can pick our cartoon style hands, which are very useful. We can pick background styles, click on the resolution, and we've got some things here. So we can always change the title. And this is quite useful. The video ends when the animation ends or the animation and the audio ends. That's quite useful as well. We can also select the transition type here and this will override all the scenes, which is useful. And we can select the erase mode and we'll come to that later. We've got our scene transitions here and things can swipe left, swipe right, swipe up, swipe down, do a mixture, or we can do camera panning. So I'm just going to talk about this. I think this is really good and I think it makes it look more professional. I'm going to go to swipe right and you'll see what I mean in a moment. So I'm going to click here, I'm going to go to preview and we're going to see what happens. So I'm going to start my preview again. and you can see scene one just swipes out really fast and it goes into scene two. However, if I go and change my settings to camera panning, here I've put a camera pan move in and I've put it over scene one and scene two. So in scene one, I've just got it as the standard default size, and in scene two, I've moved it down to the sort of lower right hand corner. Let's see how that plays out when we do our preview. So what I've done is I've made sure it moves from the text of scene one to the text of scene two, and it actually takes scene one off screen. So I've placed my scene two low down in the corner, and I've placed my scene one text in the middle, and with my panning motion, I've made sure that scene one isn't in there. Now, one thing to be aware of is if I put scene one in the same proximity as scene two, and within the panning motion, it would encompass both of them, you'll see both of them. So let's have a look at that preview. So you might think that that's okay. I personally prefer scene one to disappear completely and scene two to be there second. So that's just one thing to be aware of. I think that makes a much nicer transition than the swiping. If I go to my third scene, you'll see I've got things that are on top of each other. Now, currently, eraser mode is off. We've got three eraser modes and we've got off. So, smart eraser, let's see what that does. So we can see first item's drawn in and then the second item is drawn on top of it, but where they intersect, it's erased. You might not like that, and personally, I wouldn't blame you. So if we go to settings, we can erase it with a finger, we can erase it with a razor, or we can turn it off. I personally prefer it to be turned off. Let's preview this now. First item drawn in, and then second item is just drawn on top of it. Much better. If you click on the object, you've got this settings button. Here you can flip it horizontally, but this settings button is the key one. If we click on this, we can pick the color. So we could have it as an orange. Now it will only be the outline and the lines that are orange. It won't be anything else. But there we go, we get orange. So we don't have to stick with black. Obviously you've got the rainbow add-on for Doodly, but you've got to pay for that. So if you want different colors, all you have to do is go to the setting of the object and pick what you want. I'm going to put it back to black. Staying with the settings of an object, you might have noticed in the preview, when the glasses were drawn in, we got this swish sound. So what we can do, we can specify our enter animation. We can have none, or we can have draw it in, and then we can specify a sound for when it draws in. So I've picked here badminton swing. You don't want music, you want a sound. We could have a blast, we could have a bowing, we could have broken glass. And all we do is we select it within this menu. We can preview it here. So if you want to select it but you don't want it to play, then set it to 0. Otherwise, set it to 1. You can go more than 1 if you want to, but 1 is just going to do it once. Let's have a look at how that sounds. So one thing to be aware of, it will do it at the start of when it's being drawn. It won't do it at the end or in the middle. It's always going to be at the start. And staying with the object and its position, these buttons here are very useful when you've got one thing in front of the other, and that will happen all the time. You'll have things in front of the other. If we click here, we will put the front object at the back and the back object at the front. And again, if we bring that object forwards, we're putting it on top of the object and putting the other object at the back. And that can be quite useful when you want to set sort of an order and you want to have things in front of each other. So I've just covered 10 tips to use with Doodly. These are tips that they're not obvious tips, but they're there. You need to do a little bit of exploring. But do let me know, has it been useful to see these tips? Would you like me to do any more tutorial videos on Doodly or any other videos on Doodly? Do let me know in the comments below and have a great day. Thank you.